Yeah, you already know. Number one boss bitch, she Gotti in the building. Bad bitch cartel, no print CNT CEO. Yeah, so I'm getting ready to start a little vlog thing, you know, call it the G vlog. And basically, I'm just gonna welcome you into my life, you know what I'm saying? We'll talk about music, my music, other people's music, things that's going on in the industry. My first topic I'm gonna start with is gonna be the Husel, previously known as Musiq Soulchild. Now, don't get it twisted. This is not to bash him in any way, because I am a diehard Musiq Soulchild fan. So, I'm going to give you, and I'm also an artist, I'm going to give you two point of views, two perspectives on my opinion, because I recently read an interview that he did on some online magazine, some shit, whatever. But I read the little interview, and I agreed from an artist standpoint. So I'm going to give you, you know what I'm saying, give you my artist opinion, and I'm going to give you my fan opinion. And I want everybody, you know, interact. Like it if you like it. If you don't like it, then dislike it. Please, comment, subscribe. Let me know how you feel. I will make it my business to answer back. If I don't answer back immediately, please understand. I'll be busy. But I promise you, you will get answered. I'm not one of those type of rappers, you know. I try to respond to anybody that interacts with me, whether you're a fan or you're just interacting, period. Hopefully you will become a fan if you're not already. So, you know, enough of that. Let's get into this. All right, so everybody knows that Musiq Soulchild has now been calling himself The Husel. You know, he's seen always wearing black and dark shades, gold chains, things like that, which is very different from his original image as Musiq Soulchild. Now, in this interview, he made a statement basically that, you know, he's doing this because this is what's selling right now. He's doing this from an artist and a producer standpoint. When he turned on the radio, this is what he hears on the radio. You know, people rapping and doing so in auto-tune, because that is what the Husel is, an auto-tune rapper, such as Future or Lil Durk. Alright, so this is my thing about that right here. And I'm going to give it to you from my artist standpoint. From an artist standpoint, I understand. You want to make music that you can make money from. You know, you want to follow the trend, what's going on, you know. So, therefore, I understand where he's coming from that point of view. Yes, I understand. And, you know, big ups to him for, you know, being bold enough to reinvent himself and change his image. And, yeah, that's my standpoint on that. From an artist point of view. Now, let's get to the good shit. As a fan, as somebody who listen to Love, Don't Change, I'm going to be honest, I don't like no album names and all of that, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to keep it funky, but I tell you what, the nigga got a good voice. Any song of his I ever heard, I always loved it, you know what I'm saying? I can quote words, sing them the whole nine, you know what I'm saying? And I say this, your fans are going to be disappointed. Not all of them. You know, because there are going to be some of them who may possibly be into that auto-tune. You know what I'm saying? But a lot of your original Musiq Soulchild fans are not going to follow over and be fans of The Husel. Now, however, The Husel may reach a different, you know, fan base that Musiq Soulchild did not reach. Possibly, I don't see how or why, because Musiq Soulchild was making real goddamn music. The Husel is doing this new age shit that, I mean, I don't know. But, you know, I find myself as an artist also being guilty of trying to conform to the new age. But what I try to do is conform to the new age while still being myself. Like, you know what I'm saying? All right, y'all like, you know, down south, southern sound. I could do that. I lived in the south for 10 years. I'll give you the southern sound. You know what I'm saying? But I'm not going to not be She Got It. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to change my name and turn, you know what I'm saying, be somebody else, because no, either y'all like me as I am or you don't like me. And the way I feel is this, whether I have 100 fans, 1,000, 10,000, or 1 million, those are my fans that I got from being myself, being me, who I am, who I was born to be. This is my everyday self. So that is my opinion on that. Not saying that he's not being himself. Maybe the Husel is his other self, you know, but that's just my opinion. But hey, listen, today, you know, all the rappers want to be singers, all the singers want to be rappers, you know what I'm saying? So, I guess it's trending right now, right? Well, listen, you might catch me singing a hook, but that's about it. I'm not singing no verses. I'm not auto-tuning nothing. I don't think I'm T-Pain or Future or nobody else. None of that. She got it. Always was, always will be. That's all there is to it. No Prince and T. You already know. Look out for me. I'm on the come up right now. Yes, I am in the Bad Bitch Cartel. Yes, that is ran by Miss Chi. Yes, she is the first lady of No Limit Forever. So salute the fucking tank, you Nimrods. Holler at your motherfucking boy!